Harper Design and Harper Audio present Life, I Swear. Intimate stories from Black women on identity, healing, and self-trust. Curated by Chloe Dulce Louvouezo. Read by Joniece Abbott-Pratt. To Mayel, our Mamush. It begins and ends with you. You are the catalyst to my bloom and my grounds for renewal. We are growing up together, with hearts intertwined. I feel more human because of and with you. You are the reason I never want to be erased from this world. My stories will always be yours, too. To my late grandmother Joyce, who would exhale deeply, fascinated by the stories that live in strangers. You planted the seed and told me to write a book, knowing that even at 10 years old, my life was ripe for blank pages. So I did. To the family I've never known and the family I've lost, despite the mystery of each other, you remain a home base, a beginning, and a checkpoint that informs my essence, even in my wandering. And to the young Black girls and women, in every corner of the world. This collection was curated with you in mind. Our spirit cannot be denied because it vibrates from our veins. Nothing can take what runs through us, so long as we know that to be true. Foreword, Elaine Welteroth. I met Chloe in 2012. When I say I met her, I don't mean we shook hands and made polite small talk. I mean from sunrise to sunset, we curled up like kittens at the foot of our mutual sister friend's bed in Harlem as I listened intently to her tales of harrowing betrayals and crushing blows that she weathered with heroic grace. In a world where most wade into the shallow waters of new friendship slowly and with cautious optimism, we joined hands and cannonballed right into the deep end. And in those deepest of waters, I saw straight into her soul. Little did she know then, I'd journeyed a parallel path in love that led to a nearly identical heartbreak I hadn't yet processed and a rebirth I was still undergoing. When she cracked open her broken heart to let me in, I felt blood drip from my own. If that sounds dramatic, it was. That's because in all my 20-something years on this planet, never had I met someone who I felt so instantly connected to, someone whose mere existence held up a mirror to my own polarities. It would be cliche to call her a kindred spirit, but I couldn't shake this knowing that our lives were divinely intertwined. We'd joke that we were made from the same stardust, so it never came as a surprise when we attracted the exact same men or when we even got mistaken for twins by strangers. It just felt like physical evidence of what we both knew to be true in the spirit realm. In each other, we had found an extension of ourselves. But it was much more than just the physical resemblance that struck me. The resemblance was soul deep. A healer seeking the path toward healing, a free-spirited adventurer, and a pragmatic perfectionist warring over which will take the wheel at any given moment. The trusting naivete of a kid at heart, with the stubborn resilience of a woman warrior who may have shed blood in the battle but refuses to lose the war. In each of her contradictions, I saw my own. Since the start of our sisterhood, that fateful Super Soul Sunday in Harlem, we've lived lifetimes together and co-created many more harrowing tales. Along the way, I've had the privilege of witnessing Chloe's resilience on repeat in real time as her life has continued to unfold with one remarkable act of faith after another. As a sister, I feel the pain and joy in her experiences as if they were my own. As a fellow writer and author, I am jolted by the impact of the poetic honesty in her words. Now, as she prepares to bravely share many of those stories with and for you, stories that bonded us back then, I am overwhelmed with a sense of pride to write alongside her and so many other Black women warriors whose narratives fit into a larger tapestry of our collective traumas and triumphs. This book is an embodiment of the power of all the untold stories that bond us, each one an essential part of our collective experience as Black women. Across the diaspora, Black women are so often the backbones of our families, the prayer warriors, the protectors, the strong friends, the ride or dies, the teachers and healers of the world, a world that has turned its back on us throughout history. Still, we rise. But who can we count on to hold us down? We do so much explaining of ourselves, of our value, of our identities, yet so much of who we are is never truly seen or understood. The exception to that rule is when we are in the presence of our sisters. There is an immediate exhale, an intimacy even, in the wordless exchanges that reset our nervous systems and fill our bodies with a sense of safety. That's because our stories are as intertwined as our traumas. The same is true of our healing. Each time I let someone hold a piece of my heart that's been hurt before, when a sister friend trusts me with her truth, when an elder tells her story for the first time, when we listen, really listen, and hold sacred space for sisterhood, we instantly come into awareness that we are all more interconnected than we realize. What I know for sure is this. There is so much healing locked up in the stories Black women never tell. But a powerful ripple effect is set into motion with each tidal wave of truth that is introduced to the collective consciousness. This is how radical healing happens. The inverse is also true. When we withhold or hide the parts of ourselves that need healing, we rob the collective of becoming whole. Because here's the thing about healing. It isn't linear, and it's never just about you. When we heal our wounds, that healing is felt across lifetimes and lineages. Generational chains are broken when we engage each other in the process of the inner work we simply cannot do alone. When you tell your truth, I become more accountable to my own. When I engage in the brave act of acknowledging my pain aloud, it gives you permission to access yours too. We become mirrors to and for each other. Your healing is my healing. Your freedom is my freedom. Your work is my work. Your peace is my peace. How would you show up differently in the world if you knew this were true? How much more honest would you be? How much more grace would you give? How would you show up differently as a friend, sister, daughter, and mother? Each story in this book extends an invitation to you to dive deeper into your own self-reflective journey in order to access deeper levels of healing that can only happen in sacred community. This book offers a safe space for Black women to feel seen in our most vulnerable and authentic truths. Through Chloe's meticulous curation, she invites you into a community that blossoms with each breakthrough and that challenges you to do the work you were put here to do. The Space We Deserve. Chloe Dulce Louvouezo. This book is an undertaking of the heart. Life, I swear. To me, that saying captures it all. The irony, the challenge, the faith, the resilience, the sweet manifestation, the ugly chaos, and the calm. All the ebbs and flows that frame how we experience and interpret this life. Life, I swear. was one of those things my girlfriends and I would exhale after long conversations about how the growing pains both depleted and revived us. Life, I swear, became how we described polarities that brought irony to our feelings and to the realities of our worlds. It is these polarities and the stories that form them that make us human. In my mid-20s, I took a one-way bus to New York City with one bag, no job, and the curiosity to find out what life could offer if I finally gave back what I had deprived myself of until then, forgiveness of the imperfections of my journey. I committed to extending myself an olive branch, to make peace with the ways in which I had been hard on myself. My sister friends, Brooke, Elaine, and Offeibea, became my hand-picked family, filling the voids where blood and lustful love lacked or disappointed. In confidence and in trust, we validated each other as we fumbled our way through figuring life out and gave ourselves permission to live in both faith and fear. In those coming-of-age years, we were forced to face some hard truths about our regrets and immaturities. God was requiring us to lean into clumsy and uncomfortable seasons of maturing, while also teaching us what forgiveness and being kind to ourselves meant. It was through this sisterhood that we experienced emotional alchemy, a journey of mindfulness of our vulnerabilities, our faith, and our innate wisdom. And it was through our shared intimacy that we grew deeper intimacy with ourselves that rooted us in the beauty of our stories. I love stories. I love the texture and the nuances of them. I love understanding our whys of everything. Why do we feel the way we feel? And what makes us do the things we do? For Black women, being in community as we unpack and make sense of our whys and our lives is an outlet that nothing else in the world can provide. Our sharing of uncertainties, vulnerabilities, and trepidations about life makes space for a special intimacy, an intimacy we are rarely afforded. Because the world expects the strength of Black women to be demonstrated through restraint of our true selves. Challenging seasons of life remind us how much intimacy and feeling understood are gateways to personal healing. After a trying year in 2019, I started to document conversations with other Black women about personal stories that have enlightened us to answer some of these questions. As deep dive dialogues in my Life I Swear podcast and as stories in this book, I've always considered myself a cat with nine lives, rebirthed in each new season. One that emerges from fires at times, scarred but layered in stories that together tell the tale of the dance of this life. It's been an incredible one. I've lived in 11 cities, 5 countries, and traveled the world. I've been in abusive and loving relationships, home-birthed a prince of a son, grew a family, been a single mother, raised by a single mother. I've taken risks, led a spontaneous life, explored artistry, and ebbed and flowed through loss and glory. Tell me something you've been through, and I bet I can relate. Give me a story of promise and hope and faith, and you're speaking to my spirit. Give me a story of pain and struggle, and know in my eyes that I deeply understand. I spent years trying to find the words to articulate the breadth of what this journey of life has meant to me. Putting pen to paper through stories of love and loss, discovery and rebounds is the only way I know how. The pages that follow are an anthology of stories from Black women about the falling down, the cycles, the post-traumatic growth, and the resilience. In curating these stories, I've had the blessed opportunity to speak to other women of the Black diaspora from around the country and the world, all who have shared from a place of vulnerability and truth. Their stories capture a range of experiences and reflections that offer nuance and variation of our human nature to discover new facets of ourselves. They represent voices and sentiments of our time, chronicled for our collective healing. Being honest in my own storytelling and being receptive of others has helped me find the grace in still figuring it all out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.